but we're still anticipating riding the train this summer.
Wow, no kidding. This was such a fun trip.
Oh, all of these train trips. And given the cost of gasoline right now.
Yes, take the train.
And airfare.
Yeah, take the train.
So we're going to be riding a lot of train.
Right.
It'll be a lot of fun. But that's something that we've been doing anyway, in spite of gasoline and airfares and
stuff. It's just fun.
It's just a great way to go out for an adventure.
Right. We've even gone so far as to ride the Front Runner, our local commuter train.
Yeah, just buy a day pass.
Yeah.
And go out there and just get on the train for fun.
Exactly.
I, of course, have been a rail fan my whole life.
I can see that.
And I used to go out and take still pictures, but in 1984, I got a hold of a pretty decent video camera and I started shooting video.
Oh, man.
This is the Grand Canyon Railway. This is Modena, Utah.
Oh, boy.
And this was a fun shot. But my old video camera, for the era, it was great.
Right. I think it still looks pretty good, though, considering...
And it got really good audio, which for me was key.
Right.
Today there are drones.
Isn't that something?
Now, we don't have a drone. I'd like to maybe get one, but we sure have some friends with drones who are really good at shooting drone footage.
Especially Ian.
Oh, man.
Adventure is just grabbing a camera and chasing these trains.
Yeah, just getting out on the road.
Yeah.
It's a vacation and it's a train chase and it's an adventure.
It's a thrill.
And of course you meet a ton of people.
Oh, a ton of people with a common interest.
And at this particular meeting here, almost everybody here was from another country.
Right.
They were from Holland and Japan.
Germany.
Germany.
Oh, man.
People from all over. This is 844.
Isn't that a neat locomotive?
We've had a lot of fun chasing this one all over the place.
Oh, spur of the moment fun, too.
Yeah, sometimes you just find out it's going to be somewhere, and we get in the car and take off. Last week, of course, we were showing 3985.
Yes.
Which is soon to be restored.
That's going to be cool.
And I put a couple of my old shots in here from the 1990s, and people said, how much footage do you have of that?
Or mileage?
I've got probably well over 2 hours of just really nice run-bys of this locomotive. So here's a bit more of that footage.
Wow.
So, as we mentioned last week, the locomotive has been donated to the RRHMA, which is Railroad Heritage of Midway. It's easier to just say RRHMA.
That guy, yeah.
And the head of that thing is Steve Sandberg.
Oh.
And they've been running out of Minneapolis, Minnesota, but they just had an opportunity to buy shops in Silvis, Illinois, not far from Chicago. So they're moving their whole operation there.
That's an excellent location.
That's a great location. And here in just a few weeks, all of this equipment that's been donated to them by the Union Pacific is going to be moved there. And we are going to attempt to follow that move as best we can.
I hope so.
Because just another great train adventure. What could be funner than that?
Oh, exactly.
And then we'd love to follow along with the restoration of two of these steam locomotives that they're being given. That'd just be an enormous amount of fun. And our good friend Ed Dickens is going to be helping out. Of course, he's the head of Union Pacific's steam program. And he and his crew are the ones that completely restored 844 and 4014, the big boy. And while he won't be working directly on any of these locomotives, he's the one who really put this whole deal together. He's been engineering it secretly in the background now for probably well over a year at least. And so he will be supervising the move across Union Pacific tracks and at least lending moral support to this program as it goes forward. So that'll be really neat.
No kidding.
It's going to be nice to be back chasing trains again.
Oh, no kidding. I've looked forward to it.
Man, I'll tell you why. So maybe some of you watching will also be joining in this magnificent chase as we follow this locomotive to Silvis, Illinois. And if not, you can follow it here on the channel.
Right.
Now be sure to like and share and all of those things, this particular video. But what you really want to make sure is that you're a subscriber to the channel. Because you don't want to miss any of this,
heavens,
of course.
No.
Of course not. And the easy way to subscribe is with the blue button. Right there, the blue button. Well, we're not sure how you found this video on the internet. We hope you didn't find it boring, and we will see you here on Tuesday because we're still building some model trains. See you then. Bye.
Bye.